you know, certain things in this world just don't mix. Oil and water, dogs and cats, Sonny and Cher, giraffes and whales, sharp objects, and balloons. I know you haven't given a lot of thought to this, but it is pretty fascinating. What if you could find a sharp object and a balloon and make them live in perfect harmony? I'm pretty excited. I think you will be too. Ugh, failed again. I'm Steve Spangler, and I'm all about making science fun. For the last 20 years, I've been teaching ways to turn ordinary science experiments into unforgettable learning experiences. I have an amazing team who will do whatever it takes to affect the way people think about science. And to do that, I live by one motto: make it big, do it right, give it class. Remember that episode where we took the pencils and we put the pencils through the bag like this? We called it the leak-proof bag. The secret was the fact that this plastic bag is a polymer. Polymer is nothing more than this long chain of molecules, and we literally put the pencil through this long chain of molecules and it sealed itself back around, keeping the water from leaking out. The question today is, could you do the same thing with another polymer, a rubber balloon? See, balloons are made out of latex, and latex is nothing more than a long chain of molecules. If we wanted to do the same thing with the pencil through the bag, you could, but there's a problem with the balloon. It's under so much stress and so much pressure. Watch. See, most of the time we don't think about blowing up a balloon and think about the way that the molecules are oriented here in the balloon. We just think of blowing a balloon up, tying it off, and realizing that any sharp object like this cooking skewer and the balloon are two things that don't mix. See, when we get close here, these strands of molecules are stretched so thinly that just a mere presence of that sharp object and it pops. Let's do it again, but this time we use a clear balloon. This is a 9-inch clear party balloon that you would find like a helium balloon. But by using a clear balloon, you get to see some of the properties of this latex balloon that you couldn't see with a colored balloon. First and foremost, look at how stretched and clear it is in the very middle of the balloon. You'll notice two things. You'll notice that there's a lot of rubber around this area here that's not stretched tightly. And there's not a lot of rubber that's stretched tightly right here. So this is the area that's most like that bag when we did the pencil through the bag. The molecules are not stretched as tight. They've got a little bit of give to them. So if we're ever to try to take a sharp object and stick it through, this would be the point of entry, and this could be the point of entry. If we could push it all the way through, you literally would do surgery on a latex balloon. Now it's time to get a sharp object. It's an ordinary cooking skewer, the kind that you would find at the grocery store. Except this one here, I'm not gonna take any chances. I want that tip to be super, super sharp. So I'm using just a small amount of really fine sandpaper to get the perfect tip. All right, it's time for surgery. If I'm gonna try to take this and put it through the balloon, I'm gonna try to go through this area here where it's the greatest amount of excess latex rubber. When you push and just keep on pushing, making sure that your hand is at the bottom, because every once in a while, okay, all the time, it will pop. Watch this as it comes out the other end. Ah, and that's how you would do surgery on a regular balloon. Now you'll see the little bit of air. Well, you can't see the air. I can feel it. You can sometimes hear it. A small amount of air coming out here as it's coming through. Of course, the air is leaking out. So unlike the leak-proof bag where the water didn't come out, the air will come out. And we can slowly start to pull this back out again here. You can see the air goes down, and finally we're at the very end and the balloon can pop. So the secret here is stress. And let's just use one of these clear balloons. Let's use a Sharpie pen to draw something on the balloon to see what it looks like once it's inflated. In this particular case, just simple little dots. We're gonna keep them all the same size. So the goal is to keep all the dots the same size so we can compare them once the balloon is blown up. So all the dots hopefully are about the same size, but watch what happens when you blow this up. Take a look at where the latex is the most stressed. See, the dots almost disappear here in this part here. Look at how big that dot is compared to the size of the dot down here where it's relatively unstretched. Is it easy to be able to put a needle through a regular balloon where it's not stressed? Absolutely. And in fact, that's exactly what you're doing when you do surgery at this end or the end down here. Sometimes the edge of the skewer will catch, and so a small amount of cooking oil or maybe a little bit of Vaseline works fairly well to help this as the skewer tries to make its way through the balloon without popping. Again, if you were to go through the part of the balloon here where it's the greatest amount of stress, it's sure to pop. But this end right here, as you push, and that small amount of Vaseline will help, it's perfect as it goes through. You just have to look on the other end where it's coming through, and that's the perfect spot right here, and the perfect spot right here, and you can see it's fairly easy to make that skewer travel right through the balloon. Simple. So let's say you want to use this as a metaphor, an object lesson, attach some sort of meaning to it other than just teaching science. Well, one of the things that has been easy to do is to think of this as handling stress. If I want to come up against any stressful kind of situation, I have to take a look at the situation first and figure out where to enter, where to get involved, and most importantly, where to exit. And so if I took this volatile situation that's here, it's under a tremendous amount of pressure, and I guess the needle could be the source or the problem. If I try to go here, I'm trying to do a kind of a head-on collision with the problem. This is where it's the greatest amount of stress. In a negotiation, it's horrible. It's like asking mom and dad for something during tax time. Ask for nothing during tax time. March, bad time. Christmas time, good time, right? So all you're trying to do is to figure out where the least amount of stress is. And if we go in where the least amount of stress is and enter the problem, it's pretty easy to be able to get knee deep into that situation, analyze it, try to fix it, and have an exit point over here like this. So as a leadership principle or maybe a business idea or a way to be able to talk about counseling or bullying, whatever it might be, it's kind of an interesting illustration, I think, to be able to enter this very volatile situation with something that's that sharp, but you get the point, right? That was horrible, but you're gonna be using it. Well, back in the 1970s, my mom and dad bought me this magic trick called needle through the balloon. What you got was this needle, a super, super long, sharp needle that you always ended up poking yourself with, attached to some ribbon down at the very end. Now, there wasn't really a science explanation. They just said that the secret was to enter the balloon through the end and come out through the very top, and it would look as if the magician had these extraordinary powers. But herein lies the problem, because what was once a very cool magic trick was no longer a secret because of people like Mr. Wizard and Bill Nye and Steve Spangler and... Take two. All right, listen. So, see, throw caution to the wind. All the kids knew the secret because of these people on TV. So, what if you could throw caution to the wind, and instead of going through this end here that all the kids knew about, what if you could go through the side like this? See, you just poke it right through the side where everybody knows that it should pop, and yet in the hands of a magician, this is totally possible. Try that, fancy science teachers. But you see, my problem with magic is I'm not very good at keeping a secret, and I gotta tell you how this works. You just have to get some tape. So I actually just took some tape and...
I'm gonna need your card.
No, not the card. My membership card?
That's the one.
Who made you Captain Magic? Not all tape works well. You'll have to do a little experimenting, but this packing tape seems to work perfect for me. The secret here is to use this to keep the sides of the balloon from stretching, expanding, and exploding real quickly. So, you blow up the balloon, and you don't have to use a clear one for this, but it's pretty effective. Again, this is the dangerous spot. All the kids who think that they know this trick know that you have to go here and you go here. So you take a small piece of tape like this and you put it right at the spot where they know you can't go through, and you put it right there. That's number one. And one on the opposite side would be perfect if you were gonna do the skewer through the balloon. Well, you can see that if I show it to you by holding it here like this, it looks like a regular balloon. This is great. All right, let me test my luck. Watch. Tape on the side. Let's see if you can do it with the skewer. Oh, this is good. It's leaking just a little bit. You have to go pretty fast. That's the skewer through the balloon. And hopefully nobody knows how it works. Hey, Magic Man, Higginsworth, come here. Look at this. big balloon. I got a magic trick for you.
Yeah,
watch
I've
this.
Seen this one
now
before.
You haven't seen anything before. Watch this. It's a big balloon. You've never seen anybody do it like this. Look, no tape on it. And look, no extra rubber right here. This is just a huge, it's called a cloudburst balloon. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, pushing the skewer through the giant balloon. Here we go. I never was very good at that trick. Could you get the vacuum?
Thanks for that.
So with all this sharp objects going through balloons, I know what you're thinking. Maybe it's the air. What if we change the air? What if it was helium? Would that work? Well, you could use the helium.
You know, it would probably work the right way, but nobody really cares because you're just using helium. Nobody really cares about that. But
what if we used a gas that was 6 times heavier than the air we breathe? Sulfur hexafluoride. Would the needle through the balloon work the same way if you use this gas?
Once again, nobody really cares. In fact, nobody cared about this demo until we did it in 2007 on the Ellen Show. Now it seems to be kind of a staple with it. You gotta get oxygen back into your lungs or you get a little sleepy. Don't try this at home, kid. Big is worse!
Many people wonder what's magic about a magic wand. It has very many powers, like passing through a solid object without harming it. Let me demonstrate with a balloon and its holder. We'll put the balloon in its holder. And now we're going to stick the wand right through. One thing, let's add something to the mystery. Let's put the handkerchief over the wand. Now let's stick it through. Went right through. Let's pull the wand out. Pull the hank out. I bet you're saying that it isn't a real balloon. Watch.
Oh. I know it's a real balloon.
Why is it a real balloon?
Beautiful.
I like the way you did that.